100,000 credentials leaked due to an autodiscover flaw, 3 Apple Zero Days were published online, and the FBI secretly held a ransomware decryptor key. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I'm Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for September 28th, 2021. This is your weekly summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. By the way, thank you so much to Kevin and Kevin for joining this week. That has never happened before. Patreon.com/ThreatWire is the place where you can join the Patreon Alliance and keep this show ad-free. We have some excellent stories to get into today, so let's go ahead and get into the news. Now, what is AutoDiscover in terms of Windows Exchange, and how does this pertain to this show? Well, a security researcher discovered a flaw that allowed for a leak of 100,000 login names and passwords for Windows domains. Whoops. So AutoDiscover helps users set up their mail clients, like Microsoft Outlook, to automatically determine mail settings, say for an organization. But Amit Serper of Guardicore's security research team discovered a flaw in how AutoDiscover works. So if, for example, a user inputs their email address and password, Outlook would authenticate this with the Exchange AutoDiscover URLs, and the username and password are sent automatically to that AutoDiscover URL. Now that URL is determined based on the email address from the client device. So for example, if your email was shannon@test.com, the auto-discovered URLs could be something like autodiscover.test.com. It sounds fine so far, but here's the flaw. The client and Microsoft Exchange server get matched with one of these URLs for the connection to be authenticated. If authentication fails, the mail client may try to create some more URLs to authenticate with based on the user email address, like autodiscover.com, .uk, .fr for France, .es for Spain, whenever the email address ends with. So if that happens, sometimes the mail client might authenticate with untrusted domains. That means those credentials could be sent to a malicious domain. So Guardicore ended up registering a bunch of AutoDiscover domains as honeypots with web servers to test this. They registered AutoDiscover domains like autodiscover.fr, .it, .uk, .xyz, .online, there's a ton of them. Serper discovered that mail clients that use the AutoDiscover protocol were in fact sending account credentials to these domains based on the email addresses of users. So even when the client sent credentials using OAuth or NTLM, the researcher was able to downgrade the authentication via a request from the Exchange server to simple HTTP, so the credentials were sent back in plain text base 64. Guardicore got hundreds of thousands of authentication requests from various clients, including credentials for major companies and infrastructure organizations. Now, they also got over 96,000 unique credentials from Outlook and other mobile email clients and applications that work with Exchange server, and this entire test took place from April of 2021 to August of 2021. Bleeping Computer has pointed out that this was first brought to light via a Black Hat Asia 2017 talk, but Microsoft says that they just learned about this. They also stated the issue was not reported to them before presented to the media by the researcher marketing team, so they learned about the claims after it went public. At time of recording, at least 60 plus AutoDiscover TLDs have been registered by Microsoft. It is possible that others had already been registered by malicious actors as well, since some of those TLD owners are hidden behind Whois privacy restrictions. Serper recommends that organizations block top-level domains at the firewall or DNS server and use Guardicore's list of TLDs to create access rules for mail clients. Disable basic authentication, as this allows for clear text credentials to be sent. Since this is not just an Outlook issue, other applications will also have to take steps to mitigate it as well. On Thursday of last week, a security researcher who was frustrated with Apple's vulnerability disclosure and bug bounty program dropped 3 zero days for updated Apple iOS devices, along with a blog post detailing why. According to the researcher, who goes by the name Illusion of Chaos, 4 different vulnerabilities were reported to Apple following their disclosure and bug bounty program. One of these problems was fixed in iOS 14.7, which could allow for arbitrary user-installed applications to access iOS analytics data without permissions granted by the user. Now, that data included Apple Watch medical data. That data could also be available to any applications, even if the iOS sharing analytics setting was disabled. Now, this problem was disclosed on April 29th, and Apple did respond the next day, but they did not continue communications until June 3rd. Then they fixed the problem in 14.7 on July 19th. Illusion of Chaos was not acknowledged in the update, nor was the patched issue. Apple told them that they would be credited in the next update, but that didn't happen either. Now we are all updating to iOS 15.0, and Illusion of Chaos still has not received any acknowledgement in those updates for disclosing those flaws. So the researcher threatened to release the three other flaws that have gone unpatched to the public out of frustration with Apple. And they followed through 10 days later. Each of these 0 days have to do with access to data that apps should not have, nor have they been granted access to. They all include proof of concepts as well over on GitHub. The first is a gamed 0 day, which can expose the Apple ID email and name, exploit Apple ID authentication tokens, and read databases. Now, this could be used by an attacker to steal their personally identifiable information of a user or grab info about user interactions, including contact lists, who is contacted and when, and to potentially steal attachments from messages. The second 0 day is a NetHelper Wi-Fi flaw, which exposes the Wi-Fi info to apps that should not have access, nor have they been granted that access. This exposes credentials used to access a Wi-Fi network, or it could be used to track a user. The third is a NetHelper enumerate 0 day, which exposes information about the apps installed. So this could allow applications to determine if other apps are installed on a device, such as antivirus or security apps. Illusion of Chaos stated that they had waited at least a month, and in one case, at least half a year to publicly disclose these flaws. The full timelines for each of these flaws is included in their detailed blog post linked from this story. One day after the public disclosure, Apple did reply to the researcher, saying that they were investigating the issues. In the meantime, a jailbreak developer claimed to have released a fix for all three of these 0 days. However, one has not been published by Apple as of yet. I love it when y'all send me these adorable pictures of your fur babies. So these are a few pet pictures from my Hush Puppy Patreon Alliance members. Y'all, this is so cool. We currently have 860 active patrons on the ThreatWire Alliance. That's an amazing community, but I would love to see that hit 870. You can always support this content, and you keep it ad-free for as little as $2 per month. And you also get a slew of perks at the same time. So I feel like that's a win-win. And with that, onto the third news story. So back in the summertime, I reported on the Reveal ransomware attacks that were going on, how the hacking group went dark, and the master key to decrypt locked devices was released by Kaseya to help at least 1,500 victims, all of whom were customers of their IT firm. So the Reveal group made waves earlier this year by hacking into Colonial Pipeline on the East Coast, along with several other major companies and organizations. Many companies, including hospitals and schools, were also affected. And at the time, spokesperson stated that the key was given to Kaseya by a trusted third party, but we didn't know who originally had that key. Now, last week, we learned that the FBI had that key, but they withheld it for 3 weeks before releasing it to victims for fear of tipping off the hacking group. Now, unfortunately for the FBI, that didn't matter since the Reveal group went dark on July 13th, with the FBI releasing the key on July 21st. So why did they wait so long after the group went dark? It's likely the victims had to spend millions of dollars to recover whatever they could after being affected by the ransomware, and deploying this decryptor key could have helped them. Some victims actually did report to journalists that having the tool earlier would have helped, as they had already begun the work to restore systems completely or replace them, both of which involved tons of time and a lot of expenses. Now, according to the FBI, withholding that key was an agreement made between multiple agencies. It was not just the FBI making that decision. As of this month, Reveal is already back at it, and they have already attacked tracked 8 new victims. Bitdefender has released a decryptor tool as of September 16th, but this only works for victims who were hit with the ransomware before Reval went dark. Now, we can assume that this means Reval has changed their ransomware and a new decryptor tool would be needed to help these new victims. Now, I can understand the FBI withholding the key while planning a sting operation to not tip off those attackers. But once the group disappeared and they went dark, I am kind of curious why it still took another week to release it. I am wondering if the group was already tipped off in some way. Maybe that's why they went dark. What are your theories? Leave them below in the comments. Now that the studio is finished, I am back to filming content over at youtube.com/ShannonMorse. I just posted a time-lapse video of moving into this new studio space, so check that out on my channel for that behind-the-scenes content. And don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel as well. I'm Shannon Morse, and I'll see you on the internet.